Hi, I'm Tony Koski. I'm the Extension Turf Specialist here at Colorado State University. We're out at the Larimer County Fairgrounds looking at some different landscapes that we're evaluating for water needs. In the background, you might hear some construction activity, some beeping and equipment moving around. There's a lot of construction happening at the fairgrounds this week. So one of the lawns that we're staying on here is, this is a Buffalograss lawn. So Buffalograss is native to Colorado. It was here before any of us came here. So obviously very well adapted to the Colorado climate. And it's gaining some popularity as an alternative to Kentucky bluegrass. It's what we call a warm season grass. So it greens up very slowly in the spring. Probably sometime in May, it will fully green up, and then it goes dormant, turns brown with the very first hard frost in the fall. Because of that shorter green period and some physiological factors that we won't get into, it requires much less irrigation than bluegrass requires to keep it green. So you might be able to water a Buffalograss lawn one time per month, whereas bluegrass, you're going to have to water it once or twice a week during the summer to keep it green. So much more water efficient. It's not a perfect grass for every situation. It doesn't grow well in shade, doesn't grow well at really high elevations. You would never use it in Vail or Aspen. But down along the Front Range in the eastern plains of Colorado, out on the west slope, it can be a really good alternative to a Kentucky bluegrass because of its low water needs. The other parts of this landscape, we've got perennials and shrubs and trees that will thrive on less frequent irrigation. So we're using drip irrigation, which is efficient in itself, but then we got plants like Little Bluestem and Pawnee Butte Sand Cherry and Apache Bloom, which can do well on much less water than some of the more conventional grasses and ornamentals that are planted in many landscapes across Colorado.